Hi, my name is Brian McDonald, and I'm a police officer with the Rockland Police Department. My department is one of many departments that provides support and referrals to community members who struggle with substance use. In 2019, there were more than 2,000 overdose deaths in Massachusetts. Over 93% of these deaths involve fentanyl, a synthetic opiate that is over 50 times more potent than heroin. It's not just fatal overdoses that are on the rise. Non-fatal overdoses are increasing too, many due to fentanyl use.
PAARI has been selected by the Massachusetts Department of Public Health to pilot a project to use test strips as a tool to build relationships and create links to treatment and other supports. In today's videos, we'll walk through a couple scenarios to show you how you might utilize fentanyl test strips as an engagement tool for people who are at risk for an overdose. These test strips are used to detect the presence of fentanyl in drugs and may help people change their use behavior and be informed about their exposure. We think the distribution of fentanyl test strips by officers, recovery coaches, and others may also be a helpful tool to develop trust and build relationships, which will hopefully foster a person's readiness for a referral to treatment and get them on a path to recovery.
There's Anne over there. She overdosed a couple weeks ago. I know we're on our way somewhere, but I'd like to stop and just say hi to her, see how she's doing. Hi, Anne, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm Officer McDonald. Do you remember me?
I think I do.
I was at your house a couple weeks ago. How's everything going? You still in treatment? Everything going well?
I'm going here and there. I just haven't felt motivated.
All right. This is Natasha. She's a recovery coach. Like I said, we were on our way somewhere, but do you have 2 minutes?
Because Natasha has some information.
We'll leave it with you.
So there's a bunch of resources in here. There's even Narcan in here too, and fentanyl test strips.
What are those?
Yeah, so they test the fentanyl and the drugs. Nowadays, they're basically in anything, in a heroin, crack, even pill form.
This is gonna be a lot to tell you right now. Everything is in this little packet here.
So what you need is the residue inside a bottle, a baggie, and all you need is half of the bottle of water.
Or if you have a baggie, half a corner cut baggie about is another
okay,
thing.
Thank you.
Yeah. So you need the water and the residue, whatever that may be. You grab it by the blue and you put it in. Do you see the wavy lines?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so you're gonna mix it. For 15 seconds, you're gonna keep it in here for. After 15 seconds, you're gonna take it out and you're gonna place it right here. And in 5 minutes, it's gonna show you the results.
Oh, okay.
If you see two red lines, it indicates that there is no fentanyl present. And if there is one red line, it indicates that there is fentanyl present. Sometimes you might have a false negative, but always be cautious.
Okay.
Any questions for us?
Yeah, what if it tests positive? What do you recommend?
Well, the first thing is hopefully not use. If you do use and you're getting positive test results, make sure you're using with somebody. You should always use with somebody. That way if something happens to you, they can call 911. The other thing that we recommend is that you use less than what you normally use. That way your body can react to it and you can tell what's going on with your body without overdosing.
Okay.
Any other questions for us?
No, thank you so much. I really appreciate this.
It was good seeing you.
Yeah, you too.
And anything at all, any help you need, reach out to either one of us.
Cool.
All right.
Yeah, thank you so much.
All right, it was nice seeing you.
You're welcome.
Have a great rest of your day.
You too.